11 InstaWeather Plus forecast with Chief Meteorologist Tom Tesselmeyer.
Here we're dealing with some slippery conditions down on the Gulf Coast in New Orleans. Let's check out the conditions down there. Early this morning, temperatures were in the 50s with some clouds around. But just in time for the Ravens to arrive, the skies have cleared up nicely. Down there, as we've seen from Mindy Becerra down there with our live shots, a lot of sunshine and mild temperatures, 73 degrees right now in New Orleans, with a southeast breeze at about 10 miles an hour. Much different up this way. We did pick up some rain, and the rain a little less than 0.2 inches, but it was falling into some cold air, so it started as sleet and snow, freezing rain, and then the temperatures warmed, and that 41 degree high is the current temperature at the airport, so the temperatures have continued to slowly rise after that early morning freeze, and it looks like for the rest of this night, we don't have to worry about freezing conditions. The cold is retreating, on up into New England, 27 at Boston now, right around the freezing point in State College, PA, but everybody from Baltimore south, quite mild, 53 right now in Richmond, Virginia. So again, while it's still kind of moist and damp in spots, we're not expecting temperatures to drop much tonight at all. Steady or even slowly rising in many locations, so some fog may be the concern later tonight under cloudy skies with light winds. This warm front will push past us tomorrow into Wednesday, and on the other side of it, it is unseasonably warm. That's why New Orleans up in the 70s, Memphis as well, Kansas City at 75 degrees, although they're about to cool off a little bit. This storm coming out of the Rockies will track toward the Great Lakes, and another one will likely form on the front and drive that front through here, but not until late Wednesday night or early Thursday. So for Tuesday and Wednesday, the next 2 days, we get to enjoy a little bit of a thaw here, some warming temperatures, a lot of clouds around, maybe even a sprinkle or some drizzle in the morning tomorrow. Our best chance for rain will be with the front coming up and down the I-95 corridor Wednesday night. That's 10 o'clock in the evening on Wednesday, and those showers may also be accompanied by a little bit of thunder because it'll be so warm. Once the front goes by early Thursday morning, snow in the mountains indicates the cold air that'll be rushing in behind it. So our warm-up will only last 2 days. Temperatures during the day Thursday will actually be falling throughout the day. 45 to 55 tomorrow. The cooler temperatures will be up along the Pennsylvania line, the warmer stuff just south of Baltimore toward D.C. or early morning fog is likely. In the western Maryland mountains, well, it's not skiing kind of weather. This is scattered rain showers in 50s, but the cold and the snow will come back Thursday into Friday, so just have to be patient if you're waiting for more mountain winter weather. Eastern shore, 49 tomorrow, well into the 60s Wednesday. Lower eastern shore, best chance for storms there on Wednesday afternoon or evening as temperatures soar into the mid-60s before turning sharply colder for Super Bowl weekend. 49 tomorrow, 63 Wednesday with a shower or thunderstorm. Falling temperatures during the day Thursday leads to some snow shower chances on Friday and Saturday, and on Super Bowl Sunday, partly cloudy skies, a high temperature of only 35.